it's not like you're doing anything illegal, man. I'm not asking you to put any money up. Now I have to paint my damn face, damn it. Hey, I gotta do the same thing, man. It's you know, it is what it is. It's just a little bit of blue and black, or, you know, it's not gonna hurt you.
You can even do it with markers if you don't have face paint. That'd be funny, though. I don't think it'd look as good.
It'd be hard as hell to get off.
Yeah, really.
That's you have
to fucking it when you go to work the next day.
I'm telling you. I get crazy and, Ron, I don't know what you do in the bathroom, but I'm just saying. That's
Go stay on here, Ron. Go stay on here.
Yeah, ghost. Everybody, you know, big prayers and shout outs to our man Ghost. Having a hard time with family right now, so much prayers and whatnot for our brother. He'll be back. He'll be back at some point in time. So, you know, until then, you're stuck with us.
Sorry.
I did message Heather, but I don't think she's up yet. So she might come, she might jump in with us here in a bit. But anyway, I told Miss Jade that there was something I wanted to play with her. So it's kind of like a two-part here. Some of y'all probably heard this before, but we'll start off with this one first.
If you're just joining us, we are covering a developing story. We go back now to Southern California, where a VH1 bus crashed just a short while ago, spilling more than 2,000 pounds of slut onto Interstate 5 near Palmdale. The bus was transporting contestants for the new VH1 reality series, The Road to Knoxville, in which 18 scantily clad young women vie for the heart of divorced stuntman Johnny Knoxville. Officials there are struggling to control the spread of slut, which has already polluted the roadway and is spreading now down a hillside into residential areas. Let's go live. Live to Onion News Network's Brian Scott, who's live on the scene. Brian, what's exactly going on out there?
Well, it's just horrible, Anna. The highway here was not pristine to begin with, but now it's covered in all of this orange-skinned slut. I've only been here an hour. I've already seen 4 three-way kisses and 6 tattoos with misspellings. Oh. And downwind, the stench of perfume and tequila mixed together is pretty difficult to stomach.
Well, sounds like quite a scene. Brian, I understand that the sluts had been loaded onto the bus in Huntington Beach early this morning. Is that right?
But that's where it began, yes. The sluts were being transported from a negligee-wearing rock climbing contest there to a girl-on-girl paintball match when the crash occurred. There's been speculation, in fact, the accident was actually caused by some slut leaking into the front cab on the vehicle and getting on the driver.
I see.
Now, the local fire department is just not equipped to handle something this toxic.
No,
the
yeah.
problem is that we're very close to the San Gabriel River, and officials are concerned that the sluts might go skinny-dipping in it or think it's a hot tub and make out in
it. Oh, my gosh, yeah.
But we should say, too, that the crews, they're doing their best. They're just trying to keep these sluts contained with impromptu strip-offs and shooter contests in the ditch behind me.
Now, we've just gotten word that VH1 has issued a statement. It's on their website. It says they are fully committed to the safe handling of sluts.
Yes, but the EPA has urged VH1 to use perhaps a more diluted form of slut than this highly concentrated slut they use now.
Yeah, all sounds like good stuff, but I don't think VH1's gonna ever go for that. Ryan, stay safe out there and don't fuck any of those sluts.
All right, thanks, Anna.
If you're just joining,
Part 2.
Lock eyes from across the room. Down my drink while the rhythms boom. Take your hand and skip the names. No need here for the silly games. Make our way through the smoking crowd. The club is the sky and I'm on your cloud. Move in close as the lasers fly. Our bodies touch and the angels cry. Leave this place, go back to yours. Our lips first touch outside your doors. The whole night what we've got in store. Whisper in my ear that you want some more and I jizz in my pants. This really never happens, you can take my word. I won't apologize, that's just absurd. Mainly your fault for the way that you dance. And now I jizz in my pants. Don't tell your friends or I'll say you're a slut. Plus it's your fault you were rubbing my butt. I'm very sensitive, some would say that's a plus. Now I'll go home and change. I need a few things from the grocery. Do things alone now, mostly. Left me heartbroken, not looking for love. Surprise in my eyes when I looked above the checkout counter and I saw her face. My heart stood still, so did time and space. Never felt that I could feel real again, but the look in her eyes said I need a friend. She turned to me, that's when she said it. Looked me dead in the face. his ass, cash your credit, and I shizzed in my pants. It's perfectly normal, nothing wrong with me, but we're going to need a cleanup on aisle three. And now I'm posed in an awkward stance because I shizzed in my pants. To be fair, you were flirting a lot, plus the way you bag cans got me bothered and hot. Please stop acting like you're not impressed. One more thing, I'm gonna pay by check. Last week, I saw a film. As I recall, it was a horror film. Walked outside into the rain, checked my phone and saw you rang, and I shizzed in my pants. Speeding down the street when the red lights flash, need to get away, need to make a dash. A song comes on that reminds me of you, and I shizzed in my pants. Next day, my alarm goes off and I shizzed in my pants. Open my window and a breeze rolls in, and I shizzed in my pants. When Bruce Willis was dead at the end of Sixth Sense, I shizzed in my pants. I just ate a grape and I shizzed in my pants. I went jizzed okay, in my pants.
Seriously, you guys, can we? Okay.
I jizz right in my pants every time you're next to me. And when we're holding hands, it's like having sex to me. You say I'm premature, I just go in ecstasy. I wear a rubber at all times, it's a necessity.
Cause I jizz in my pants.
I jizz in my pants, I jizz in my pants, I jizz in my pants, I jizz in my pants.
Yes, I jizz in my pants.
All right, there goes your little bit of VH1, your VH1 and
what the heck? If I hadn't seen the video, I think the video is what makes it even funnier, the faces when they're, you know, jizzing in the pants. I'm like, what the heck?
So everybody that's listening, all the crowd that's coming in, thank you for coming in. If you're listening to Spreaker app, hit the title of the show, come into the chat group, or if you're listening through the website, hit the little chat symbol, come in, say what's up, and if you want to see the videos of this, go subscribe to our YouTube channel, the Dangerous Grounds Network, or just Dangerous Grounds Network. Go subscribe to our YouTube channel, and you can see all the music, the comedy bits, and everything, so you can actually watch the videos. I mean, that does make it, you know, worthwhile, especially when you have a song like this. But, you know, radio is not to be live streamed. You're supposed to, you know, use your imagination of what we're doing. I could be sitting here covered in green Jell-O naked, but I'm not. Just saying.
Are you sure? That was pretty specific. Are you sure?
Yeah. Oh, Jesus. So what you got going on this morning? How cold is it over there?
Freezing. I woke up this morning and I was like, fuck the morning, fuck the cold, fuck the winter, fuck getting old. I was just like, fuck everything. Made up my own little thing. I was just like, first thing in the morning, fuck it all. And it's too cold.
Yeah, it's... I can't... I don't know how cold it is right here. Yes, I'm always getting kinky with Jell-O. Come on, man. It's all, it is what it is. Hey, you can play in it. You can eat it. Just saying. What up, Beeson? What's going on, big guy? How you feeling, man? You back on your feet yet, or you still bedridden? That's about 100 hours below freezing. 100 hours below freezing? Oh, Lord, have mercy.
It says it's 20 degrees here.
Then we're not too far behind you at all then.
Yeah.
Well, I don't know. Give y'all a little fucking nerd. Give y'all something I guess educate your mind. See if there's anything in here that's... We're talking about 1912 plans to announce that the new $150,000 Brooklyn Stadium for the Trolley Dodgers baseball team. Wow. 1912, it only cost $150,000 to build a fucking baseball stadium. Jeez Louise.
Wow.
1920, the last of the U.S. troops depart for France. Of course, we know what that's about. Da, 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 da. 1946, President Harry S. Truman calls Americans to spur Congress act on going the ongoing labor crisis. Of course, we know that's when we were in the Depression.
Right.
1961, the United States break diplomatic relations with Cuba. Sucks. 1985, President Ronald Reagan condemns on a rash of arson attacks. That sucks. 1994, more than 7 million people in South Africa, more than 7,000 people receive South African citizenship that had previously been denied under their policies. 1999, Mars Polar Lander launched. And year 2000, the last original weekday Peanuts comic strip published after 50-year run following the death of the strip's creator, Charles Schulz. That sucks. That's why you don't see Peanuts in the fucking newspaper.
I wondered why we never see them anymore.
The only time, if I even do get a paper, it's just to read the fucking comics. I don't read the bullshit news. And there's really... William Tucker was born in 1621 today. Yeah, there's your nerd for today.
Do you remember, and I don't know if they did it in all newspapers, but in the Gaston Gazette, they used to, a long time ago, they used to have those little illusion puzzles.
Oh, yeah, the ones that you had to kind of, like, cross your eyes to see the picture in the
middle. Yeah, you had to go back and forth with it, and they drive you crazy. I thought that was full of shit, and I wish they would have never stopped doing that.
All you got to do is stick your sticky nose in the middle of it, keep your eyes crossed, you'll eventually see it.
No, that don't work. That didn't work for me anyways. But I do got a lazy eye, so maybe that's why, I don't know. But anyways... But those were cool. And then they had the little treasure hunt thing or whatever, the gold rush. I don't know if they still do that or not.
Whoops. Okay. What the hell happened there? Okay. Well, I had to bring all that back up then. I don't know why this fucking shit got so big. It used to be really small to where I could see both screens at the same time. So... So, how's everybody else's morning going while I refix the fucking YouTube shit?
Ron's talking about some Cool Whip. Use Cool Whip when you go down to eat the pie out. I can't keep up. I cannot keep up with him. He said, I dated a lady with lazy. She was straight up alcoholic morning, noon, and night. A lazy eye.
Oh, Lord, Ron.
You're so funny.
Ron's a fucking trip.
He's like the comic bit in the morning time. He's a trip.
He is. So I try to keep getting his ass to come on with us one morning. Just one freaking morning, but, you know, it's all good. Yeah. He's always in the chat making his funny ass comments and stuff that we can read to everybody. So it's all good. But, you know, still, one day, Ron. One day.
Yeah, come on. You should, Ron, because I think it'd sound funnier coming out of your mouth for everybody to hear.
Just. Oh, Lord.
Just stuff coming out sometimes. He
does. Hilarious. He's got some funny ass shit. He really does. He's got some funny ass shit. Okay, there's his comedy bit for there. Ah, shit. So, what is today? Tuesday? Wednesday?
Wednesday.
You sure?
Yep. My phone told me so.
Okay. Well, this, okay. You're right then. Damn, I thought my daughter's appointment was fucking tomorrow. It's on the 5th. Well, I guess it's not until fucking Friday. Damn it.
Well, you said you're coming to Gastonia then Friday, right?
Yeah, I'll be in town Friday.
Okay. So I'm off on Friday, so... I'll be waiting on my Rip It. I'll be waiting on my t-shirt.
well, I mean, I'll be in town. I'm probably going to end up staying the night at my homeboy Shane's house Friday night. So, just to let everybody know, I know everybody hasn't seen BWI on Facebook or anything like that for a while. We are under construction at the moment. We are redoing some things. I just got a hold of BizCentral yesterday. They're getting our annual report.